to the Big Slice Music Show here on That's Manchester Television. I'm your host, Paul Lewin, for the evening. Please get in touch with the show, hashtag That's TV and at Slice Music Show. I'm joined by Chris Flynn this evening and Dickon Wright. Welcome to the show.
How are you doing? You all right?
Yeah. Great session tonight, SSR. Really loved it. I mean, if we can kind of wind back a bit, because you're a real seasoned musician with regards to being well-respected on the Manchester music scene and further afield. I mean, where did it all begin? Because you've been writing for a long time now.
Yeah, well, I've always written songs right from being a very, very early age. It started out as quite a cathartic thing. You know, it's like a bit of therapy, isn't it, writing a song? And then soon you realise that, you know, nobody wants to hear about your inner thoughts and kind of depressing that's going on in your head. So I think where I'm at now, I don't write about myself, I don't talk about myself, I just make up little stories and little characters, and you know, that's the kind of bed of what I do, really. So a character based songwriter.
I mean, that magic can take you anywhere though, can't it?
Yeah. I think you know, whether that's into a character like Pandora or Anita that we'll hear a little bit later, I just think that, you know, telling stories is the best way to get a different kind of point over.
So is that in all your songwriting? Because, you know, the song we're going to listen to next is Pandora. Do you go into a certain frame of mind when you're writing that music?
Yeah, I try to write stories, as I've said, but then I also think about what other people would like to listen to. I mean, I think with Pandora, there's a sense that everybody's felt the emotions that are, you know, prevalent in Pandora, and you know, it's a bit, you know, Pandora is about a little bit of a moment, thinking back to the past. You know, it might be, you know, like the video like highlights this, that you know, it might just be a point. You might be in a pub somewhere and you might just be thinking about somebody, or even bump into somebody. Everybody moves on in life. And I think Pandora it allows us to have that little cheeky thought about the past, really, and just think about, you know, a past state and a past way of being.
Yeah, I mean, there's some great videos out there which we're going to talk about. We're going to tease people with, actually, because they've been really well produced, haven't they?
But
should we get our teeth into our session at SSR?
Yeah.
Oh, let's do it. Fantastic. This is Chris Flynn. This is from our SSR sessions. This is Pandora.
I've been sunk, I've been a liar, and I've been dumped. Now I'm falling to pieces, falling to pieces in your arms. I've been on top of the world, and I've been under a spell. I've been taking the punches, now I'm falling to pieces in your arms. Do you feel sunk, shrunk, inspired, a little drunk? Can you spare all the speeches while I'm falling to pieces in your arms? I'm in love with you, girl, but I've been under a spell. Done my time with the leeches, now I'm falling to pieces in your arms. While I'm falling to pieces in your arms. Da-da-dum. 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 I've been dumped, I've been sunk, I've been a liar, and I'm still drunk.
That was, of course, Chris Flynn with Pandora. That's a tune, that, mate. That's one of your older songs, though, isn't it?
Yeah, it was. It's the we've been recording an album for the last couple of years, and that was the first one that was ready to go. So we put that out and did the video, and then finding the other ones to fit with that has been a bit complicated, shall we say. So we've got the album ready now. That's going to be out in February.
So if I can come to you, Dickon, with regards to that process, because you've worked with Chris now for over 16 plus years, if you dare to
say around 16 that. Years.
Fortunately or unfortunately.
By the way, it's pronounced Dickon.
Dickon, yeah. What did I say, Dickon?
Yeah, is this a common mistake? It's all right.
I believe it's a literary name, isn't it?
It is, yeah.
Oh, annoyingly, it's a very nice name.
There's a book called The Secret Garden.
Oh, I'll have a read. I'll have a read of that. So, I mean, with regards to Chris's music, you know, you session for so many musicians, you know, how do you bring that what you do into the band with Chris?
Well, we've known each other since uni, and it's just part of what we did at the time.
I think the great thing about Dickon is he's a fantastic musician, and he knows how to play to a song. He doesn't overplay and he doesn't underplay. He's very much a part player.
So Anita is going to be out in February time.
It's ended up being a Pandora side and an Anita side. So Pandora's the head track on the Pandora side.
Yeah.
And then Anita is a slightly different character with slightly different things going on in her life. So, you know, the other side tells that story, basically.
Yeah. I think we should get our teeth into it, teasing for long enough. Fantastic. This is Chris Flynn and this is Anita.
High rise, hard time, dead end street, point to the sky. Anita Hepburn had that look drilled in her eyes, but she dared to dream. Anita runs away from what she felt she had to say. Was there a better way? Anita breaks away. Gone without a trace, off to a better place where nobody knows her name. They all spoke with affection, 'cause they knew she offered lies. She was given direction, now she lives on borrowed time. Felt she had to say, was there a better way? Anita breaks away. Gone without a trace, off to a better place where nobody knows her name. Never speaks another word. If she never speaks another word, you'll read Anita's name on every subway wall. We'll be right back. headlines. She missed all the deadlines and eats her breaks away. Gone without a trace, off to a better place. Now everyone knows her name.
That was, of course, Anita by Chris Flynn. That's a great tune. Real nice vibe with a lot of great music. But I said not overplayed, but it's got a real presence about it, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, you know, I think that one has taken the longest to realise, but, we're really happy with the album version now. It's a real escape song. The story for that comes from me wandering around Salford. When I first moved to Salford and first lived in Salford, there was some graffiti written on a subway wall, and all around Salford, to be quite honest. Yeah. Anita Hepburn, and you know, there was all sorts of expletives and words. And
we'll make a feature-length film with
all
these characters.
I think we could, if we had the money. You know, it's like, you know,
if you're out there, there's a film to be made.
Yeah, absolutely.
Stay tuned to the Big Slice Music Show. Still on the sofa with Chris Flynn. Go and get the kettle on. See you in 3 minutes. Welcome back to the Big Slice Music Show with me, Paolo, and hope you're having a good Sunday. Still got Chris Flynn and Dickon on the sofa. I'm absolutely buzzing. We've had some great music already. You've already missed out. Still some music to come. Chris, if I can kind of tap into some of the videos, because what we talked about before the break was kind of the storytelling. The music videos are so well oiled and so well produced. Is there going to be more of that as you go along?
I would like to think that there is, but obviously, budget-wise, to keep producing those kind of quality of videos, then, you know, we're in discussion. I think there might be another one.
So does everyone in the band have an influence on the sound as well, with your keys and on double bass?
I think that, you know, luckily I've got quite a unique identity as a songwriter in terms of voice, but I think the songs command a certain way of playing and realising them, and again, we're very lucky that we've got, you know, a team of talented musicians
that
are willing to step in, and you know, there's never any problem. You know, Dickon sometimes plays double bass, sometimes he plays keys, sometimes, you know, he's doing something else mad. So the general thing is, if the part works, it sticks. If it doesn't work, we just get rid of it.
Yeah. Oh, you're not messing around, eh, Chris?
No.
So we can talk about Take Flight, which is on your new album. It's going to be released in February. Is that going to be part of the same storyline within the album as well?
Yeah, well, it's Take Flight is kind of the overarching theme, really, because as I've said, there's a lot of, like, you know, shall we stay, shall we go, shall we come back? So Take Flight really encompasses that whole kind of theme, really, and it's kind of like the umbrella theme. So the album will be called Take Flight.
Right,
so
okay.
Title. There will be like a Pandora side for Take Flight and an Anita side for Take Flight.
I reckon we get our teeth into it. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I reckon we should.
This is Take Flight. This is Chris Flynn. It's a great song. Check it out.
We took flight tonight, would you believe it? Kiss the last goodnight, together like shadows from street lights. If someone sold you the stars, would you keep the dream that was ours? Were you really holding my hand? Did we build a wall made from sand? Can't just blame it on the nights. Take flight. Do you feel alright tonight? Or should we leave it? I'll be the last good soul, around like a clown in a sideshow. I love you more than the stars. They always leave a scene in the dark. And if the night is cold where we stand, I'll never let them mess with our plans. So should we stay around and fight, or just take flight? Should we stay around and fight, or just take flight?
That was, of course, Chris Flynn on his new album. That was Take Flight. Chris, don't get any better than that. I mean, no wonder it's your title track for your album. Going forward, obviously, you just about released this album. Are you always going to be storytelling through your music, through different characters?
Yeah, I think that's a really good way to go. I find it very difficult to write about myself. You know, I'm in a relationship, got a family and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, that doesn't really make for interesting songwriting. So, you know, in a winter's evening when there's nothing else on, while I'm actually sat down songwriting, you know, I it's my own escape, really. It's my own kind of storytelling. It's, yeah, you know, nobody wants to know the ins and outs of, like, your dirty socks and what you're doing.
I've had a few songs in the charts that should sound
dirty socks.
So, I mean, you know, you've gigged for years in Manchester. You're really well known, really well respected with Regatta. You've had a bit of time off to bring your album together. You're into the new year now. What are you going to do with that album to get it out there?
Well, obviously there's lots of radio coming up, etc. I think Anita is a lead track, so we'll probably put that out as a single. You know, rather than being a single, we'll put it out as a lead track. We've got some gigs coming up from February. We've got an album launch gig at a wonderful little venue called The Castle. Have you ever been?
Beautiful,
to that?
Absolutely, yeah. Stunning sound as well.
Yeah, it's
perfect
great. I mean, you know, there's lots of like little boutique venues around Salford and Manchester that, you know, keep things quite contained, so you can get like 80 to 100 people in a back room. Mm. And it just makes an absolutely lovely gig if you get that rammed, which we usually do.
You so, always do well
absolutely,
with it. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's going to be the first time we've had, you know, the band together. The last time we got the full band together was at the Lowry about 18 months ago, 2 years ago. So we're going to try and get as many players involved for the album launch. So I think you know, when we go out as a band with drums, it can be three piece, and then, you know, obviously we've got strings and keyboards and all that kind of stuff that can go on top of that. So we're looking at a bigger production for the album launch gig to just, you know, play the album live, basically.
Yeah. So I want to talk about Dumped. We played that tonight in SSR. It's a real shame not to let the listeners and the viewers have a look at that. Should we get our teeth into that one?
Yeah, that's
a sneak it in there.
Yeah, yeah.
This is an older one by Chris Flynn, nonetheless, a fantastic track. This is Dumped.
Shall we go for a little walk? The old canal don't look so old anymore. It's surprising what you find when the stars still shine behind the clouds. Shall we go? Can we take a look down the lanes where our memories rust. I always think of you when the sun comes shining through the clouds. Will you go? Will you take a look? Coconut won't flow so cold anymore. Whatever works with you until the light comes shining through the clouds. La-da-da, da-da. Shall we go for a little walk? Shall we go for a little walk? Shall we go? Shall we go for a little walk?
That was, of course, Chris Flynn with Dump. When he rolled the track, still great. Is the video online for that one still?
It is. Still online. Still out there.
Yeah.
Check it out.
So where's the best place to find your music? Because your album's out in February. Where's the best place? Twitter, social media?
Yeah, Twitter at Flynn280 and www.chrisflynn.org.uk. You can get all the information that you need about the album. As I say, the album is going to be a 10-track final and then 8-track download, so that the vinyl version is going to be the director's cut, if you like.
Can't wait.
Couple of extra tracks we're not going to release.
You're going to keep them in the bag.
We're going to keep them in the bag for the people that really want to listen to real music. You can have one.
Yes, yeah. Anyway, Chris Flynn, thanks very much. Mr. Wright, thank you very much for coming on to the show.
Mr. Wright.
Wow. Been an absolute pleasure. This has been the Big Slice Music Show on That's Manchester Television. I've been Paul Wynn. See you next week.